Okay, so my name is Amit. Today I'm going to talk about difference between C++ vector and Python lists. Basically, I'm going to cover up that what is the time and space complexity that when we use both our containers. When we try to use C++ vector, which is also a dynamic container, same as arrays, that we can store the content onto the array, and we need not to resize it. Somewhere something is malloc or something, we do not need to use it. And similarly, in Python, we have lists, which is a container of heterogeneous elements, but it's again a dynamic. So this is the content. Initially, I'll just cover up that what's the difference between scripting and object-oriented language. Then, what are C++ vectors and Python lists. Then I'll compare memory used by vector and lists and time complexity of vector and list using. I'll try to demonstrate it using code, practical code maybe. So first of all, I just want to brief about that what is what are different what is difference between the scripting and the object-oriented language maybe. Okay, so I just came to the scripting language first. So in scripting language, as we all know, we also say it as an interpreter language. There are a few like Python, Perl, TCL, JavaScript is also an interpreter language. Here, the source code is fed to the interpreter, and the output or exception is provided by interpreter at that point only. So interpreter takes one line at a time and executes that line. Interpreter will terminate the program as soon as it finds any error on a particular line. Then, in object-oriented language, we provide a source code file. It may be a .c file, .cpp file. It's fed to preprocessor. Preprocessor removes the comments from code. It includes the header files into the code, replaces macros with the actual values. Then it goes to compiler. Compilers, as we know, compiler's task is to do parsing, verifying the code syntax, lexical analysis of code. Then, object-oriented language or a procedural language you can say also, it has an assembler in between which generates the machine code. And the machine codes for the different programs, maybe. Like we have something as a.c, b.cpp, c.cpp, some different source code files. Those are linked in the linker, those .o files that the machine codes are linked. And then it's loaded into the RAM using loader. So I have not shown loader here. So it's a complete process where we get an executable and then we can run that executable. So I'll start with what's vector in C++. So C++ from C++ 98, then now the standards have C++ has released C++ 20 also. So C++ 98, 11, 14, 17, and 20, these are the standards. In this, they have defined a standard template library. which is a library of common programming data structures, something as lists, stacks, arrays. But lists in C++ and lists in Python are a bit different. Lists in C++ means queues, that is double-ended queue, while list in Python is a heterogeneous store of elements. So we can just think that arrays in C, vectors in C++, and lists in Python are a bit similar. So if we see what's vector, vector is again a dynamically allocated array. of contiguous location, elements are stored at contiguous locations. We can just using a for loop and using the index operator, square brackets, we can access the vector elements. Then vector keeps some space reserved for in advance for storage of some variables. Whenever the space is exhausted, it again relocates the bigger space and copies elements to the new space, deletes the present or the old space. And these are a few of things about the sequence containers. Vector is a sequence container. Then C++ also provide associative and different containers. Associative containers are maps, similar to map in similar to dictionary in Python. So in Python, what's list is a data structure, data store, a container to store the elements. It's not immutable, that is, it's not read only. Again, on list, it's similar as 1D, 2D, or ND arrays. List comprehensions can be done. Then we can store heterogeneous data and all. Again, list slicing is also allowed in Python. So I'll just go on to the memory usage. First, if we want to look at how good the algorithm is, maybe in any programming language, then we have to do space and time complexity calculations for the algorithm. So first we'll do the space complexity, that is the memory usage by the basic data structures, vectors and list. And then we'll do the time complexity by adding, removing. So in time complexity calculation, we'll be doing using these operations. By creating a list of 10,000 elements and squaring them, then in doing some insertions, 1,000 insertions, then searching an element and deleting and shrinking the container. So I'll just open up my code things. So here there are two programs on the right. One is So one is about the size of the list. So I have used sys.getSize of operator.
Amen, Bhavin here, can you increase the size a little bit?
Sure, okay.
So basically if you have four windows. I guess with the control shift plus plus.
Now it's a bit better.
Let me check the stream as well. Yeah, it's better. Maybe a little bit more if you can.
Because it's already, I have four windows, so it's already fitting. But I'll scroll down maybe for.
Yeah, if you can increase the size, then we will have to scroll down. Yeah.
Okay. So if we see on the top right corner, there is a window which says size of list. So in Python, I have used get size of function imported by sys. So whenever I have created an empty list, that is A, then I have added one element B into the list B, and I've just tried printing the size. So I'll just do size of list here. So the third entry we can just ignore. This is the size of int. So here, as you can see, the size of empty list here is 72, then if we have added an element, it takes it as a 8 byte and size increases to 80. So let me just go to the C++ size, C++ code for size of vector. So here what I have done is, I'll just increase it. So here what I've done is I have taken a vector which is A1, then vector of integers, then I have taken a vector B1 which has 3 elements. So let me just reduce it to 1 element. Vector of char, vector of double, so I'll just make it same as Python 1, and then I'll just do a G++ size of vector, and I'll do that slash it out. So how I have calculated the size of vector here is I have called a template function. So in C++, template function is a generic function which can be called for any type. If I replace in place of int here any float or a double or char, then I need not to change the function definition. That is, I need not to overload the function. What I need to do is the function will remain same, because in place of ints, it's working on the template type t. So here I have taken the size of template, that is size of int will be 4, and then the size of container. So it will be, if we have an empty container, so it will be 0, while if we have a container of that is 1, so it will have the size of 4 itself, that is 4 bytes. For long, it will have the size of 8. So I'll just try to replace it with long. Then I'll again compile it, and its size of it. So C++ also keeps some space for bookkeeping of its containers, that whenever the size which is present in C++ vector, it's reallocated. Whenever, so let's suppose it allocates the size of 10 elements, and when it finds that 8 elements are allocated, so it reallocates the size to another 20 elements and deletes the old memory space. So all the memory allocation is done with the allocator class in C++. Now I'll just open the time complexity code. So here in time complexity, I have imported date time module, and I'm using the functions as now, function as now to calculate the current time, and then I'm just printing the time difference using my dot microseconds for the diff, that is on the object I'm using dot microseconds. So in the first example, what I'm doing is I'm creating and squaring the list. So here I have created a list of 10,000 elements. Each element is having value 5. Then in this list comprehension, I have just squared the list. That is, I have multiplied it by, I have just squared that, then it for 5, it will become 25. At start, before taking the list, before starting the list operation, I have just calculated the time in start. Then I will, after doing all this creating and squaring the list, I have again calculated the time in end. I have done a diff, and then I have just printed it in microseconds. So I'll just do time complexity dot python. So it says these all outputs are for the different operations. For creating and for creation and square, it's taking 1419 microseconds for the first part, this part here. Then let me go to the C++ code here, the similar C++ code. It will be time complexity dot cpp. So in C++, I have used a chrono class, which is provided by std namespace, and chrono provides the functions as now, which can be type scoped to high resolution clock. So what I have done is I have taken a vector, again I have taken a vector of size 10,000, initialized it to 5, then using the for loop I have squared the elements, I have calculated the start time, stop time, and then I have calculated the duration using the duration cast in nanoseconds, and I have divided, so for nanoseconds when it comes I have to multiply it by I have to multiply it by 1000 to get in microseconds. Okay, I'll just do it. So I have, I'll do C++ 11 and time complexity.cpp. Let me execute it. So here we can see that C++ is taking a huge lot of time as compared to Python. That is for creating and squaring the similar vector data structure. That is, we are creating a vector of 10,000 elements, initializing those elements to 5, so here, and then squaring the vector. I have just calculated in nanoseconds, then I have multiplied with by 1000, so it's quite big as compared to creation in Python. So now in the second step, so basically for any container, what we need to do is the time complexity can be measured in three or four operations only. That is how much time the container is taking to be created. If it's big, then if we want to append element at last, then how much time it's taking, or maybe in mid, and then if you want to search element in a container, then it again depends on the function which is available for searching, or maybe the code logic as well. But I'll be using two functions which are provided by Python and one function provided by C++ STL only, and then maybe deleting or removing the some elements of the container, then how much time it's taking it in resizing. So the second operation which I'll be doing here is I'm appending 1000 elements having value 10 at end of the list. So I have again taken up date time now timer start one. Using the range based loop, I have appended 10, and I have appended one more element, 49, at end, because I'll be searching the element 49 in the next step, and then I'm calculating the time. So here in the second step, we can see it, Python takes 147 microseconds, while the similar code in C++ pushing 1000 elements. So it takes, I'm doing it using for loop, I'm doing pushback. Similar code is taking quite a big amount of time as compared to C++ in terms of the time complexity. So, and third operation, what I'm doing is, so now both the containers, list and Python, have 11,000 elements, 11,001 elements, and last element is 49, because in step two, I have just appended 49 here. So in the third step, in the third operation, I'm just finding the element in list. So I'm just finding it using if. That is, if 49 in A, using in operator. So using in operator, it takes 262 microseconds. So these readings microsecond readings I have taken it from Python 3.7, but now I'm I'm running it on 2.7 because I don't have that computer on which I have created this program. But 3.7 is a bit faster as compared to 2.7. So that's why these readings are. Then the first method is using the in operator. And then the second method is using the index function, which is provided by the list container. So what I have done is I have I'm doing a.index of 49. So index, if I can find the index of 49, and then at end, I'm just doing the same. That is making a diff and then printing diff in microseconds. So diff, finding the index for diff is 259 microseconds. Now, if we go to the same code in C++, I'm using just find function from begin to end. So find function in C++ is a linear complexity. So it's taking a huge time. Then removing, so now we have 11,001 entries. Initially we have the entries of 10,000 entries of 5, sorry. And then we have 1,000 entries of 10 and last entry of 49. So what I'm doing is I am removing or erasing first 10,000 elements from the list. So this is how I'm doing. I have taken the slice and I have just initialized it to empty list. Then I have checked that after removing, because initial 10,000 entries were of 5. So now if initial entry is 10, so I'll just say that entries are removed. So now it says that erase 10,000 elements, and after erase and resize, it's taking 198 microseconds. While on Python 3.7, it was taking 38 microseconds. Similar code in C++ for removing, I'm using erase function, v.erase. So erase takes two iterators, that is the begin iterator from beginning to the 1000 element. And then I'm doing a duration cast, same, and multiplying it by 1000. So it's taking these much microseconds. So it's somewhere around, I think, it's somewhere around 1 minute. 1 second it takes, not 1 minute, 1 second it takes, somewhere around. So yeah, these are the things which I wanted to share: the time complexity of vector and list, and space complexity of vectors and lists. In Python, we may use a different module, a different package apart from date time. We can use something else, but I have found this, so I have used this. Again, it depends on the precision, how the function implemented in the particular package calculates the time. So the time may differ, but yes, we can see there is a huge difference between the Python and C++ time complexity of a similar package, similar containers, which we use often. So that's all what I want to share with. If you have any questions, you can just post on the chat, maybe.
Yeah, that was a nice analysis, Amit. So there are a few comments. Folks, if you have any questions, please post in the chat. So Nikhil says, I think nanosecond to microsecond, you should divide by 1000, not multiply. So there is one comment about
nanosecond. So nanoseconds is 10 raised to power minus 9, and microseconds is 10 raised to power minus 6. So we have to multiply it, right? By 10 raised to power 3 to make it to microseconds. Because nanoseconds is a smaller entity, microseconds is a bigger entity, right?
Let me. Yeah, so yeah, we need to divide so that we get a small number. Basically, 1 nanosecond equal to 0.001 microsecond.
Just a second, let me.
Sure.
So if we have, we are there in the nanoseconds, we are multiplying with 1000, then we are getting, okay. So yes, I initially was having this multiplication only. Yeah, so we need to multiply, so that's why, right? We need not to divide it, we need to multiply it, right? We get 1000 nanosecond is equal to 1 microsecond. So I think multiplication is correct.
So we are getting the answer in microseconds, is it?
Yeah, we are getting answer in
microseconds. And we want to convert it to?
No, it's... We are getting answer in nanoseconds, duration cast is of nanoseconds, and I want to show it in microseconds. So I think that's correct, right? Multiplying by 1000 is correct.
Okay. Let me check if there are any other questions, comments. No. So there was another comment by Akshay that he found something interesting, which is get size of 0 is 24. That's what all he is saying.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. Thank you. Then.
Yeah, it was a nice analysis of all the lists and vectors.
Yeah.
There is another comment by Vijay. Oh, he's saying time complexity of C++ is high. Is this due to multiple built-in function calls to perform operations on vector?
So, basically, see, in C++, a vector container is a template basically, and template has. And like C++ has changed a lot from C++ 98 to C++ 11 and to 20 again. So yes, it can be due to the decoration of functions. Maybe we can say we are generalizing a function for every kind of data type. This can be due to that. But yes, since C++ it's more closely to, because it's similar to C, it's more closely to machine. The space complexity would be less because we have pointers in C++ where we can just directly look at the machine address, maybe memory address, and then we can play with it. So it has more in terms of power to nearly have means power to actually go play with the memory, but yes, time complexity is more because we have templates and it's a bit heavy now as compared to earlier C++.
Okay. I think that's all we had as questions.
Okay. Thanks.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Thank you.
It was a nice talk. Yeah.
Bye. Thanks.